you know, in the work we do, those stories become such a big part of that person's life that they tend to self-medicate, as you know, or you may be aware of, with alcohol, drugs, substances, certain behaviors, because they don't feel good enough because they have bought into that story about themselves, which is not true.
Mm-hmm.
And we have seen, I've seen profound changes in people who actually show up, and even any kind of yoga, they show up, and where the facilitator, the teacher, is trying to get the person to sort of connect with that mind, body. Often people are, there's a huge disconnect. There's the body and there's the mind. The mind does their own thing and the body feels it, but there's no integration. Yoga has a way of connecting that.
Mm-hmm.
And the messages that's generally given by the facilitators, I mean, if you're going to a studio where the teacher comes from that in-depth training, they try and integrate certain messages where there's a shift.
Mm-hmm.
Talk just briefly about the process of the shift. How long does it take, or how long can it take?
Everybody would have come to yoga seeking some sort of solace from their life.
Yes.
So if you have had a life where you've experienced a lot of trauma, so you should not expect, see, if you have experienced, you know, 10 years, 20 years of trauma.
That's right.
So it's not going to change overnight, or it might also change overnight. It depends on the individual. So the shift which you're talking about, you know, the word in Sanskrit, you can say vairagya, that discriminative capacity which comes, it takes time. But if you have that sort of desire for it and you put yourself into the practice, then your desire and your prayer, and you know, that will itself carry you. You need not do anything more. If you have found a guru who is there to guide you, who knows, you know, they are well studied in the scripture, and they are somebody who practices what they preach, and you have found somebody like that, like we had Swami Dayananda in our life, and then all you have to do, like I said, is show up, and you show up with an open mind and open heart, and sometimes even that is not there. You are unable to open your mind because Guru says something and you resist, because for however, you know, say you're 35, 37 years old, or maybe you found him at a later age, you're 60 years old. For 60 years, you've been thinking one way.
Yes.
And so, you know, you resist. Okay, so you pray for that.
Yes.
You pray for the resistance to go away. And over time, it goes. It's just showing up and being consistent.